Hi there, it's Tarmel, your instructor. I'm going to provide you with a small tutorial on downloading Sentinel data from the Copernicus Open Access Hub. This portal provides data for satellites Sentinel 1, 2, and 3. Today we're going to look primarily at Sentinel 2. If you point your URL to sci-hub.copernicus.eu, you should end up with a website that looks roughly like what I've got open right now. Depending on whether or not you've been here or you're using a public access computer or your own, they may ask you to accept the use of cookies. If so, you can simply click on the OK button at the top and then move on forward. Feel free to look through this page, read the documents, and explore a little bit. But what we're going to do is head on over here to the Open Hub and click on there. This should bring up the main access for getting this data that we're interested in. Now, to actually access and download data, we do need to log in. So if you don't have an account, go down to the sign up, create a free account. If you already have one, then simply fill it in as I have here and click login. Once we're in, we're going to be able to actually download data, and if we click on this little icon at the top, we can see that we are indeed logged in and that we're allowed to not only search but also download some of the data that we find. So the first thing that we want to do is understand these buttons here. When this toggle is at the top with the four arrows, we can easily pan around on our map until we get to a location that we might be interested in downloading data for. So I'm going to head down to somewhere in Brazil here, and I'm going to zoom in. We're going to take a look at this town called Curitiba. This is where I was at a conference a little bit earlier or later in 2019. But we're going to then slide the slider down to the bottom. It's going to allow us to draw a box or an area of interest that's going to help us search for the data that we are interested in for this region. Now we can very quickly simply click on the little magnifying or search button and then wait while it searches through the archive to see what's available. And we can see that all of the data sources for that area or that touch on this area are now highlighted. We get a tiny thumbnail view of what the data looks like. It tells us what kind of data product we're looking at. And at the bottom, we can see that we have nearly 700 pages of imagery that meet the request that we want. Or more precisely, here at the top, almost 17,441 different images. We may want to reduce this set a little bit. To do that, we can create a filter, and if we click on these options over here, and if it's not open, we can click this arrow, we can come down and say, well, we only want Sentinel-2 data by putting a checkbox in there, and we can also indicate a date where we want to start to acquire data from. So let's go, let's say May 2019 to November 2019, somewhere, let's say, at the end. And then we can roll that back up, click on the search again, and let it refresh this and see how many fewer images we need to actually look through. Depending on the number of options, depending on the period that we're setting, we're going to have more or fewer results, and the processing might take a little bit longer. Notice now that we have only 330 products, and they're all listed as S2, which is Sentinel-2. There are two different Sentinel-2 cameras, A and B. It tells you here which one we're looking at, and the MSI tells us that we're looking at a multi-sensor instrument. And we can scroll down and look at quickly these thumbnails. We'll see that some of them have a lot of clouds, some of them are much cleaner, and that there are 14 pages of imagery. And we can simply click through those things and see what it is that is available to us. Of course, we can zoom out to see the boundaries of the four Sentinel tiles. It gives us an idea of what kinds of data coverage might be available to us. And as we scroll down, I'm going to just quickly look at this one. It looks relatively clear. If I click on the zoom, it shows me that it's this scene that I'm interested in. We click on the eyeball, it will bring up a quick view for us. We can see that it's a nice clean looking image. It shows us the extent as to where that data set exists. And then we can look under these summaries, the products, the instrument information, the platform information, and get a real sense of what that data looks like. We can then look at all the data and so on, but if this is something that we want to download, down at the bottom right-hand corner, we can simply click on the Download Product button. That will pop up an object. Do we want to open it automatically with an archive utility? That's usually not the best way forward. It's best to choose to save that file, and then as we wait, it's going to download into whatever location our downloads go to. This may take a few seconds if you've got a fast connection. It may take several minutes to hours if you have a slow connection. But I'm going to let this download and I'll be right back when it's ready to show you what the next steps would be. Okay, we can see that the file has now downloaded. We're going to then move that somewhere where we can work with it. I'm just going to make some room on my desktop. And I'm going to drag the file over. This file is a zip file, so we need to decompress it to work with it. So we can double click on it. Depending on the operating system, you may need to right click and choose to decompress, but the archive utility will then go through and take all of the files out of the archive and produce a new folder in this location with all of the structure that is supposed to be in there, as we can see from the original dataset file. We no longer need this screen anymore, so we can actually close it. And if we're no longer using Copernicus, we can actually shut that down and clean things up as we move forward. Okay, that process is now finished. So we have the original zip archive, and now we have the corresponding folder with the data that was in there. If we open that up to see what's in there, we can see that we have the same structure that we had for the data as we saw online. All of this is really important. There's metadata in here, there are different formats of the data, but we can go into this granule and down to the image data, and we can see that there's 10, 20, and 60 meter spatial resolution data. And we can see all the individual bands. We can use the metadata to bring this directly into PCI. We can take a look at this in a graphic viewer. These are large files because they are high spatial resolution, so things might take a little while. So here we have it. This is not in a remote sensing package. We don't have access to the individual bands here, but we can zoom around and take a look at some of the detail to understand what this image actually looks like. So the next step would be to take this data, open it into PCI, and start working with it. But now we have a workflow for getting data from Copernicus onto our computers so that we can start to work with it. And this stuff looks amazing. We might be familiar with Landsat data, but this blows it out of the water in terms of the detail that we can see. And just zoom in a little further. We start to see the individual pixel level. This is the level that we get at 10 meter spatial resolution. Okay, I hope you enjoy the data. I hope this tutorial was useful, and happy data hunting.